Hello students, myself Dr. Sheetal Kulkarni and I'm going to teach you life support instruments pacemaker. Pacemaker is a small device that placed in the chest or abdomen to help control abnormal heart rhythms. This device uses electrical pulses to prompt the heart to beat at a normal rate. Pacemakers are used to treat arrhythmias. Arrhythmias are problems with the rate or rhythm of the heartbeat. During an arrhythmia, the heart can be beat too fast, too slow, or with an irregular rhythm. A heartbeat that's too fast is called tachycardia, and a heartbeat that's too slow is called as bradycardia. During an arrhythmia, the heart may not be able to pump enough amount of blood to the body. This can cause symptoms such as fatigue, shortness of breath, or fainting. Severe arrhythmias can damage the body's vital organs and may even cause loss of consciousness or death. Pacemakers can relieve some arrhythmia symptoms, such as fainting. A pacemaker can help a person who has abnormal heart rhythms resume or more active lifestyle. Each electrical signal normally begins in a group of cells called the sinus node or sinoatrial node. As the signal spreads from the top of the heart to the bottom, it coordinates the timing of heart cell activity. The heart's two upper chambers, atria, contract, and the contraction pumps the blood into the heart's two lower chambers, the ventricles. The ventricles then contract and pump the blood to the rest of the body. The combined contraction of the atria and ventricles is a heartbeat. Pacemakers use low-energy electrical pulses to overcome these faulty electrical signals. Pacemakers can speed up a slow heart rhythm, help control an abnormal or fast heart rhythm, make sure the ventricles contract normally if the atria are quivering instead of beating with a normal rhythm, coordinate electrical signal between the upper and lower chambers of the heart. Coordinate electrical signaling between the ventricles. Pacemakers that do these are called cardiac resynchronization therapy, CRT devices. CRT devices are used to treat heart failure, prevent dangerous arrhythmias caused by a disorder called long QT syndrome. Pacemakers also can monitor, record your heart's electrical activity, heart rhythm. Newer pacemakers can monitor blood temperature, breathing rate, and other factors also. They also can adjust heart rate to changes in your activity. Here the few reasons are shown on the slide that for pacemaker operation, that is bradycardia, tachycardia, heart blockages, long QT syndrome, and heart muscle problem. Bradycardia is a heartbeat that is slower than the normal. Heart block is a disorder that occurs if the electrical signal is slowed or disrupted as it moves through the heart. Heart block can happen as a result of aging, damage to the heart from the heart attack, or other conditions that disrupt the heart's electrical activity. Some nerve and muscle disorders also can cause heart block, including muscular dystrophy. Aging or heart disease damages sinus node's ability to set the correct pace of heartbeat. Such damage can cause slower than normal heartbeats or long pauses between the heartbeats. The damage also can cause heart to switch between slow and fast rhythms. This condition is called sick sinus syndrome. A pacemaker can help regulate your heartbeat after the procedure. You need to take certain heart medicines such as beta blockers. These medicines can slow down heartbeat too much. You faint or have other symptoms of slow heartbeat. For example, this may happen if the main artery in neck that supplies your brain the blood is sensitive to pressure. Heart muscle problems that cause electrical signals to travel too slow through the heart muscles. Pacemaker may provide cardiac resynchronization therapy for this problem. CRT devices coordinate electrical signaling between the heart lower chambers. Components of pacemakers are pulse generator, pacemaker electrodes, timing and control output driver, and sensing amplifier. Implantable pacemakers. The implantable pacemakers, along with its electrodes, is designed to be entirely implanted beneath the skin. Its output leads are connected directly to the heart muscle. The pacemaker is a miniature pulse generator and is powered by small batteries. The circuit is so designed that the batteries supply sufficient power for a long period. Since the pacemaker is located just beneath the skin, the replacement of the pacemaker unit involving relatively minor surgery has become a routine procedure. For implantable circuit, the basic requirements are the components used in the circuit should be highly reliable. The power source should be in a position to supply sufficient power to the circuit over a prolonged period of time. The circuit should be covered with a biological inert material so that the implant is not rejected by the body. The unit should be covered in such a way that body fluids do not find a way inside the circuit, thus short circuit the batteries or result in another malfunctioning of the circuit. Types of the implantable pacemakers. The first one is the fixed rate pacemaker. The type of pacemaker is intended for patients having permanent heart blocks. The rate is preset, say at 70 BPM. The rate can be varied externally in implanted units by magnetically actuating a built-in relay. Since the fixed rate pacemaker functions regardless of the patient's natural heart rhythm, it poses a potential danger because of competition between the patient's rhythm and that of the pacemaker. Demand pacemaker. These pacemakers have gradually almost replaced the fixed rate pacemakers because they avoid competition between the heart's natural rhythm and the pacemaker's rhythm. The demand unit function only when the RR intervals of natural rhythm exceed the preset limit. R-wave triggered pacemaker. The ventricular synchronized demand type R-wave triggered pacemaker is meant for patients who are generally in heart block with occasionally sinus rhythm. The pacemaker detects ventricular activity and stimulates the ventricles after very short delay time of some milliseconds. If there is a sinus rhythm, the stimulating impulse will occur in the ventricular depolarization. There is a systole, the unit will stimulate the heart after presetting time. Ventricular inhibit or R-wave block pacemaker. The ventricular inhibited type pacemaker is meant for patients who generally have sinus rhythm with occasional heart block. The circuitry detects spontaneous R-wave potential at the electrodes and the pacemaker provides a stimulus to the heart after preset a systole. Atrial triggered pacemaker. This R-wave triggered or atrial triggered pacemaker, the pacemaker detects the atrial depolarization and starts the pulse forming circuits after a delay so that the impulse to the ventricles is delivered after a suitable PR time. Major advantage of these pacemakers is the ability to provide maximum augmentation of cardiac output at changing atrial rates to meet various physiological requirements. Dual chamber pacemaker. These devices are capable of treating the majority of those patients who suffer from the diseases of sinoatrial node by providing atrial stimulation whenever needed. In these devices, both the atria and the ventricles are sensed and stimulated as needed while maintaining proper synchronization of the upper and lower chambers. Pacemaker working and types. Pacemaker consists of a battery, a computerized generator, and wires with sensors at their tips called electrodes. The battery powers the generator and both are surrounded by a thin metal box. The wires are connected to the generator to the heart. A pacemaker helps monitor and control the heartbeat. The electrodes detect the heart electrical activity and send data through the wires to the computer in the generator. If the heart rhythm is abnormal, the computer will direct the generator to send electrical pulses to heart. The pulse travels through the wires to reach the heart. Types of the pacemaker: external pacemaker, internal pacemaker, and permanent pacemaker and temporary pacemaker. Pacemakers can be temporary or permanent. Temporary pacemakers are used to treat short-term heart problems such as slow heartbeats, thus caused by heart attack, heart surgery, or overdose of medicines. There are different types of permanent pacemakers. The first one is single chamber pacemaker, dual chamber pacemaker, and biventricular pacemaker. The first one is single chamber pacemaker. In this type, only one pacing lead is placed into a chamber of the heart, either the atrium or the ventricular. This type of pacemaker has one lead that connects the pulse generator to one chamber of your heart. For most people, we use the single chamber pacemaker to control the heartbeat pacing by connecting the lead to your right ventricle lower heart chamber. Depending on your symptoms and the type of pacing you need, we connect the lead to your right atrium upper lead chamber, upper heart chamber to stimulate the pacing in that chamber. Next is dual chamber pacemakers. Wires are placed in two chambers of the heart as it is shown on the slide. One lead paces the atrium and one paces the ventricle, closely resembles the natural pacing of the heart. With two leads, this device connects to both chambers on the right side of your heart, the right atrium and the right ventricle. The doctor programs the dual chamber pacemaker to regulate the pace of contraction of both the chambers. This pacemaker helps the two chambers work together, contracting and relaxing in the proper rhythm. The contraction allows blood to flow properly from the right atrium to right ventricle. Depending on the pacing needs of your heart, a dual chamber device may be an appropriate option for you. Biventricular pacemaker. This pacemaker, also known as cardiac resynchronization therapy CRT device, has three leads connected to the right atrium and both ventricles. We use the biventricular pacemaker to treat people with arrhythmias caused by the advanced heart failure. For many people with heart failure, the left and right ventricles do not pump at the same time. Our doctors program the biventricular pacemaker to coordinate the correct contraction of the ventricles so that they both pump together. Coordinating the ventricle contraction helps your heart pump blood more efficiently and can relieve your heart failure symptoms. The treatment is known as cardiac resynchronization therapy treatment because it resynchronizes the ventricles pumping action. Thank you, students.